No matter if you're just entering the job market or you're coming out of the job market and you want to clear up some of your financial clutter, it's always important to protect your identity. That's why we thought it was important to come to Tranconi Segarra and Associates, a CPA firm headquartered in Williamsville. We're here with Lisa Merkel. Now, Lisa, tell us about identity fraud.
Identity theft is just that. It's not someone physically stealing anything from you. It's someone physically stealing your financial identity. They're looking to take over your banking, your social security information, so that they can act as you to conduct business online, in person, at stores, retail outlets, anywhere where they can act as you on paper and use your funds, your credit cards to make purchases.
So let's break it down. Let's start with your social security number. Is there ever an appropriate time to be giving that out?
Yes, just be very careful. Never give out your social security number unless it's absolutely necessary. If, for example, you're applying for store credit, if the merchant demands it, take your business elsewhere, especially if they insist on writing it on your check. If you're solicited by phone, do not ever give out your credit card information, your bank information, or your account number or anything like that, just to be safe.
Now, what if we're not in a store? How can we make sure that our online transactions, our online shopping is secure?
Shopping online is just as important safety-wise as shopping in a store. Make sure your online credit card charges are handled through a secure site or in an encrypted mode. One way to make sure you're doing so is to make sure that your website that you're conducting your business on starts with HTTPS instead of the usual HTTP.
Now, what about our credit score? Is our credit score a good way to sort of gauge if there's been any identity theft?
Oh, absolutely. You'll want to monitor your credit by looking at your credit report, which you can do for free 4 times a year from one of the 3 major credit bureaus, Experian, TransUnion, or Equifax, and just check to see if there's been any unusual activity. If there is, you can put a stop to it immediately. That's the best way to shut that down and get your credit report back looking accurate.
Let's talk about tax return forms. All of your information's right there. When do we know that we can dispose of those forms?
We recommend 7 years. That's the general rule of thumb.
Now, with these records, what's the best way to dispose of them?
Another very common question. Shredding is the most common form of disposing of your documents. Sensitive documents, though, if we could backtrack and just define that very quickly, would be anything that contains your social security number, your bank account number, credit card numbers, your signature, medical info, legal info, passwords, etc.
All right, well, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And all this information can be a little bit overwhelming, so it's always better just to go in and talk to a certified public accountant.